Who is Wayne Dyer? I know he's a spiritual being, but what are your metaphors for yourself? Who are you besides that metaphor? That metaphor is so all-inclusive.
Yeah. My metaphor is that I am not in the world. The world is in me. Mm. I really feel that in every cell of my being, the universe exists. It's like I'm on like a pharmacy. I mean, I can create, what do I need to heal this body, for example, if healing is what I'm talking about. Who Wayne Dyer is this ability to, if I need Valium, to create it. Sure. Deepak tells me the story of when he went to London, and there was a guy next to him drinking. He had 8 drinks before they had gotten halfway there. And finally he said to him, he said, you're my buddy. He said, I'm going to buy you a drink. And Deepak said to him, I'm making my own. And it's like, that's knowing great. That. Like, yes. I mean, I know that who I am is those birds you hear out here right now. I mean, when I see them flying, I soar with them. That's who I am. I am all of it. I mean, I'm not separate. I'm not even separate from you. Like I said before, like I can wiggle this finger because I believe that there's a connection between some kind of a thought which is invisible and the wiggling of this finger. But I can't see that connection. I can't get a hold of that. And if I believe in the oneness of it all, that means that if you can wiggle your finger, that same oneness is there. Yeah. I've got to detach myself from my separateness and believe that I can't be you. I am it all. I am the sun that comes up in the morning. I am the birds that fly. I am the flower. I am that invisible force that is in every living thing that allows it to be. That's
who
I am.
How do you help somebody who sees themselves as separate, not only from life, but every sense of life? How do you help somebody like that to bridge the gap to where they remember who they really are?
The only way you can do it, I think, and I've been at this business a long time of trying to help people and writing books about it. A lot of books I wrote long before Erroneous Zones that were about counseling, and I was a therapist for years. I think that the notion of that when the student is ready, the teacher will appear.
Yeah.
So it's like all I can do is help people to get ready. That's all I can do. And see, I mean, I picked up the Bhagavad Gita 3 years ago, okay? Now, I've had the Bhagavad Gita in my library since I was in college, but I've never read it. And I've seen it, I've seen it 100 times.
Sure.
So finally, one day, I'm here, and I pick up the Bhagavad Gita, and I read it, and I say to myself, it's about time they wrote something like this. This is really terrific. Okay? Then I see that it's about 2,500 years old, or 6,000 years old, or whatever it is. All right?
And it's like, but
it's been there all along.
Yeah.
But I wasn't ready. But when I'm ready, it's like, it soars into my life. And I go to the mailbox, and what I need is ready. And it's like we were talking about earlier, when I need to give a speech, and I need to recite a poem, or even with prosperity, if I'm feeling like I need to have more money or to more my investments to be, but it's like it all gets, the right person shows up and the right thing, it all gets handled.
Yeah.
It's like trusting your intuition and knowing that everybody has it. So all you can do is help people to get convinced that they have this power within them, that it isn't something I have and you don't. It's something that you have, but you haven't used yet. And the fact that you haven't used it yet is no reason to judge yourself badly or even to be mad at yourself. You ought to be saying, I haven't been ready, you know? Now I am. And as soon as you acknowledge that you're ready, when the student is ready, then you'll find your teachers appearing, and your teacher might be like my little kids who walked into your room.
Yes.
Or when John asked me, he said, will you do this interview? My first inclination was no. I am here doing something else. I'm here with my family and all of that. And then I got this, I meditated on it, and I got this really nice letter, and it was like, and I thought, I've got to talk to Tony. I've been wanting to talk to Tony.
Yeah.
And Tony's got something to learn from me, and I've got something to learn from Tony. So the opportunity is here, and we've like missed each other on a lot of occasions.
Yes.
We've been with each other, but we've also missed. We've been on the same programs in the same cities where you spoke in the morning and I spoke in the evening, and you've been gone and I've been gone, and we've been sort of like being thrown at each other, but just sort of missing.
Yeah.
And I said, we've both got something to learn from each other, so let's do that. I've heard some things about you from other people that I didn't like. You've probably heard some things about me that you. I said, the way that you get it all in harmony is that you don't ignore it. You go with each other. So you walk into my house and my children are in love with you in a second. You emit a beautiful kind of spirituality. I see that. Whatever you are going through in your life with I know there are struggles with your fame. I mean, you've come very young, very fast, very, very powerful, and I've got a enormous organization about you, and I wanted to say to you, I don't want you to get swallowed up by it. You know, I want the essential beauty that is within you to flower. And so sometimes you have to say, I said that's one of the things you got to say is no. And I like to say it, but I'm not as good at it, but I'm a lot better at it than I used to be. So it's like what I'm saying is there's a mutual thing here. There's like,
I appreciate the gift, by the way, very much.
Yeah, and likewise, I appreciate the gift of being with you. And so I just let go of all of the other stuff. I said, this is a wonderful opportunity. Let's do it. Yeah. And you know what that came from? That came from nothingness. That didn't come from anybody telling me how to do it or what I should do. That came from a
trust.
Came from my own intuition. Yeah, trust, surrender. Yeah. But my intuition said, see, I told my wife when I got that, I said, I'm not doing any interviews. I said, I'm not doing this. You know, and she said, you keep saying that. Methinks you protested too much. I said, but I'm not doing any interviews. You know, and then she said, Read the letter, and I read the letter, and I said, she said, what does your intuition say? What is God telling you? You know,
what is
God telling you? You know, how may I serve? That's my mantra. How may I serve? How may I serve? How may I serve? Always ask that. Not what's in it for me, but how may I serve? And as I kept saying that, I said, my intuition says, do it. She said, call him and do it.
I have another thanks to make when I go downstairs. Yeah.
But we do that with each other all the time. It's neat. Like that, and that, it's like trusting that intuition. You know, it's a very, very powerful thing, and it's like it never, ever guides you wrong.